Dindy versus full team. Star Ladder Finals.
Roshan, anytime VGR are nearby as five. They go for Roshan if VGR are like dealing with split push at the top lane, for example, or if VGR have a couple heroes dead. But Na'Vi can scout out the Roshan, but they cannot afford to get caught inside that choke point as five.
Up here we go. Dindy has eyes on him. There's going to be the blink, the hex, the roar. There's going to be the Chronos or some general. He did manage to get in. However, the BKB's there. He's going to jump on out. There's going to be a sonic wave coming in from the south. And now Na'Vi just melting all across the board as Mikasa able to help clean up shop. End is going to end up dropping in the meantime, though. That's going to be 3 for 3. The Echo Slam is on point. But Dindy, too tanky. Mikasa has to use the BKB. Will it be enough? Dindy, using the Spirit Siphon, will be able to break down FY. And now the Queen of Pain, taking a dose of her own medicine, has to run for the high ground. 4 for 4, and a huge double KO over the Roche Pit.
Na'Vi absolutely turning that around with Dendi's exorcism just holding them on through.
Miracle versus Alliance. Dream League Season 6.
So they can always relocate to catch him whenever he's seen anyone on the map. And they can't kill these illusions. It's now the Mutombo show with the Manta Octarine, and he's just going to be forcing lanes in, pushing towers, and it's going to be Alliance just kind of trapped in their base. Just, yeah.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
They're even going for kills with Matu with the Ice Blast.
Oh,
so.
Lim, they'll put the BKB, will be swapped out, so it looks like it will be saved for the time being. But EGM will be caught out and left behind by the rest of his team.
They're just going for the dive, honestly. At this point, they feel so strong in this game, and yeah, I don't blame them.
There's going to be a Requiem coming through from Miracle as he stands atop a loader, comes out, full damage out onto the Vengeful Spirit. Hazcan being forced back, Mind Control jumps for Miracle as well, blinking in to finish off the kill. It's a double kill for Miracle. Loader will buy back, but this could very well be a dieback. They've still got the full team surrounding him. Alliance, they need something huge. They have managed to take down GH. Loader will survive, gets himself away and back out, but Mind Control just jumping in past the Ancient, taking down Lim. Oh, double kill from Mutombo Man, and Loader, he'll almost certainly fall as well. There'll be a buyback from Lim, but netted by Mutombo Man. A triple kill for this Naga Siren that Alliance might be able to punish. They have the Orchid, they're coming in, but the backup's there, and this Octarine heal with the Radiance, it's keeping Mutombo Man alive. Lim can't quite seal the deal. He'll turn towards Miracle, but Miracle's able to blink out.
Oh, he missed because of the evasion. He actually missed Miracle with that auto attack. But Miracle might actually get caught anyway. The right clicks. Lim's going to get him.
Pops the Manta though, Miracle.
He's trying to dodge him out with the illusion bait.
Surely he can't. Oh, wait.
Oh, my God. The illusion bait. No. His TP's down. And he's going to get the courier.
Oh, what?
What is happening? Another relocating in to try to heal him up. He doesn't have boots to travel up, but GH.
I can't quite believe what we just saw.
Oh my God. He actually illusion baits them and ends up blinking, and now he's walking uphill.
He's going to take a tier 3.
He's got the blink. Are they going to get him? Oh, I'm going to relocate out.
Denied.
Oh my God. That was.
Oh.
Invoker
versus Evil Geniuses. Mars TV Dota League.
Dealing with what was happening in the Roche, or near the Roche.
Yeah.
And it was just got very funky, and with Newbie being able to kind of easily blink and travel between two spots, definitely worked out in their favor. Now coming into high ground, EG, what are they going to do to stop it? Blasts abundance here from Zai, but oh, a big move in, crush from KP, a follow-up combo comes out from SC as he shreds right through him. Quickly taking out Universe from the fight. No roar for user. No buyback will be had. Newbie sweep through the competition now, but here comes the bounce back from EG. Sumail shrugging on in. And suddenly it's going to be U9 on the retreat. Now turnaround. There goes the Eclipse. Sumail does not want any piece of it. Artisa going to be forced to pounce to low ground. SC dishes out the tornado. Will be able to catch on Zai. Turns it back. Lincoln's going to be popped now. Can they get the burst? Stuck in the ice wall there. Gets the right click. That's going to get Zai. Deafening blast. Move on in. Arteezy stuck in that same wall. Will be able to pounce and make it into the high ground, but he's still so slow. Looks like he'll be able to make it out from trouble here, but the onslaught continues as SC gets the next scythe. Going down and taking out Crit. Now Sumail and Arteezy both look to tag team him, but he's going to be able to get out the tornado. He gets the false promise and says, back the hell off. I'm the true 9K here. Bow down before me. Arteezy cannot have a say in the matter as he still continues to go to work. Unai will lose that Aegis, and now EG looking to make him pay. A pullback with the X with the pirate combo coming out. The boat is there, but SC moves on in, looks to go for Arteezy, and still will get the grab. Wicked sick, turns back tornado. The universe still finally going to be able to get the roar off, but it's in a bad spot outside the base. Will it be enough? It will not. Sumail's here now, but ultimately will not be able to help him out with the deeps. Here's the buyback of Arteezy, as it looks like this could be the final say for EG. He is just desperate now, refuses to accept that SC Invoker is just doing so much work. SC not allowing it, get the hell off me, bumps him with a deafening blast, blinks in front of him, Kaifi's gonna be there with the crush.
Holy hell, I have never
seen. It is just nonstop, don't even try it, they cannot do a thing about it.
I have never seen a single player just make EG look
he made them
utterly,
look silly.
Dude, they just look like children just like banging on their keyboards at that point.
Just, he's like, just stop it. Don't even bother.
Godly. I've seen a lot of godly invokers, and that I think might have been one of the best ones I have seen.
Admiral Bulldog versus Team Liquid. ESL 1 Frankfurt.
Split. It won't be forced to use it as of yet, but Liquid, they're looking incredibly scary here in game 2.
They just like weird moves, like, I know what's happening in their minds.
They flash the Dazzle mid now, and so Mind Control's just gonna go up bottom. I think he might even have kill potential.
Straight up with the Chronos.
Any bash?
The Bulldog's gonna come in sprouting, but it actually ends up trapping them together, so Mind Control takes the killer now. He'll look towards Bulldog, he's gonna have time, we're gonna have 5 seconds. The bash is the real Mind Control! He's got another Time Walk, he should be able to get it, he needs another bash! Can't quite get it. Bulldog! Swags it off there! Oh, it gets pinged out as well. Mind Control, he's not happy with that one. They may still be able to get the kill. Moore's moving in from the side of Liquid. But Bulldog, he certainly gets style points for that play.
They should know he's stuck though. He TP'd in.
Sprout out. Oh, Bulldog, after taunting, he might actually be able to turn this around. It's a kill, no. Don't quite have enough damage. At the same time though, Fada's playing around with Ake once more.
Team Empire versus Team Secret on Manila Major.
Rubick, maybe it's even about the Enigma, allowing Puppy to come in and Empire blow everything to try and make sure he doesn't get that combo off. Whoops, what happens now? You have a secondary life. Team Secret, they are the ones that want to initiate, and they have a target. They are staring down the Spectral Beam. The Gush will fly forward, and Ramsey's afterlife! He goes to the back for the BKBs! It's the trigger! Ramsey's caught the black hole!
Windrunner versus Team NP, Dream League Season 6.
Coming out pretty much in full force here. Vega in the neighborhood, they do want to try and contest this Roshan. And we'll see how it kicks off FN. He's going to move it in. He's actually going to start to tease away at the Rosh. Rose, he's going to have his his work cut out, though, as he's brought back into the turret. Now tries to come in to help, but a great static storm from Shoma holds him back. Doesn't matter, though, because SVG there with the song, trying to get MP time to reset the fight. Repel onto MP, they surround Shoma and FN. GA comes out with a good stun from back, holding the back, the Tombo coming in for the Kuka. Nash falling low, he keeps himself alive here. They're killing Vega Scorch, and they found two. They're looking for more. FNG will be successful with the TP out, but it's a 2-for-1 at the moment. Maybe even more as they look to close in onto Mag. MP playing around the Nyx Assassin. Can they get the kill? Yes, they can. NP get themselves a third.
It sets up for NP to succeed. They get the full duration repel on MB as well as the GA on everyone. And problem is, Drow has Diffusal Blade, but he can't use it because he's pulled, he's focused on. When Drow's getting focused, he can't use that Diffusal Blade to deal with the repel of GA.
And it looks to be a good kind of combo boat as well, but Aoi with the BKP here at that stage. Very unlikely that anyone here is Faker going to have any damage to rip through it. In fact, at the same time, though, back in the real world, they've come into Rosh. Iceberg actually picks up a triple kill as a pretty insane scrap there around the Aegis fight.
Meeple!
Versus Complexity on the International 2016.
See Dragonlance on Morphling, we see Dragonlance on even Gyrocopters, like that item is just very, very good.
So Swindle's here on the Sand King, definitely a different Sand King than we saw last game played by Execration, you know? Oh god, please relax. And takes out the courier too. I mean, that's just a knife in the heart right there. And now we're going to be looking for more. Jesse, the global silence comes out. It's going to be godlike for the Meepo. Abed spraying out nets left and right. Doesn't even matter if it doesn't catch anything. Just his ferocious presence is enough to drive back all of these black people.
Powerful right now.
It's crazy. Hamsing's going to try to TP out. Can they actually break it? Swindles is going to be focusing his efforts elsewhere, trying to get Abed stuck down. But Swindle's just limping away. And that's going to be him just scurrying around using that blink. The best visibility going in for the Burrow Strike. But man, Abed is relentless. Oh god, brings in the damage beyond godlike now. 10-0-6 on the little meeps.
Back on Titan, they just kept taking fight after fight. My Meepo has Agonies and Boost of Travel.
Alright, this is the last hold coming up here. We've got the TP back from Sand King. He was trying to push out and rat out that top lane, but has to bail out his racks are more important. They go in, they just blow up Chessy like it's nothing. Dive back immediately. This is the Hail Mary play right here. You've got Hanskin trying to do what he can. Looking for a nice little weave there. They are able to go through, get a stun up to Ovid. They go for the poison catch, but a triple man Dream Boil. It's looking nice for Puck. This is a big blink, and he gets on. The nice little soul to Ovid. He's getting low. He's got the Aegis is turning things on the lip, there's nothing they can do about it. Another Requiem comes out, the Rat is just finished everyone off, everyone's dropped down. There's gonna be no buyback on the Ember Spirit, no buyback on the Shadow King. This could be it, the Rats are under attack, Meepo is still up, still fighting, still has an Aegis, they're looking for everything they can possibly get. Swindles, there's gonna be no Epic for him, Dice, Link Strike coming back in, but oh god, they're going, they're looking for something here, and it's an Ultra kill from Abed. Can we get the Rampage? Sand King, the lone survivor, scurrying back to his base, sitting in the fountain while everything all goes down. The racks are falling apart.
Alliance versus Evil Geniuses on the International 2016.
Now looking to push up. Fear Force to buy back, but there's no buybacks from anybody for Alliance. The only hero coming up soon is going to be Ake as well as EGM in 20 seconds in Loda. He does have another bear, but that's going to be his last as he's refreshed. They lose the Racksmith. They're going to go for the base now. The tier 3 tower's being assaulted, and it looks like this might be a lost game for Alliance here, LD.
EG pulling this one out late, pulling it out in Alliance's comfort zone. Now the BKB from Sumail, the lasso, dragging the Spirit Bear away, and as the glyph ends, EG look to close this out. Can Loda hold it? Sumail will die back, actually, down for 130.
Fear, he needs to finish this. They can't do it without Fear. He's about to go down. He bought back. No, my God, they're not going to get this. They're not going to get this. They're all dead again.
EG, can they close it? Universe desperately stopping. Falling, ding, 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 motherfucker. He goes down too, and Alliance grind the triple dieback to shut down EG. Can they deathball back the other way?
There's no way. I can't believe they couldn't finish the game there. There's so much right click on everyone from EG.
Virtus Pro versus Team Secret on the Epicenter Moscow.
damage output is still, like, it's good.
It's definitely
but
good
it's still scary.
It's not bad, though. Like, with the Venge amping him up a bit, Wave of Terror on opponents, it's pretty good, especially because these supports are very low armor. 4 on the Io, 8 on the Bane. He can deal with these guys.
Oh, Envy, are you the one to die? The smoke is going to break. Son of the Syrian chains on him. They spirit up. They're expecting an Alchemist to actually be real, but it is not. And now playing Claw. Envy hanging around. Universe jumps in. He gets himself out of the wall, out of the storm in time, but Eternal Envy, the Nightmare from
the
Puppy, buys just enough time for Envy to get Venge while still dead. The Aegis Report was going to trigger. The 5 years of VP very closely grouped up. Envy is back. He doesn't have Omniblast available, so they don't have that huge injection of damage, but it's not stopping Arteezy running forward, chasing up after FNG. Now the Chemical Rage is up, but he needs more life to survive. Backing out, Poppy also can be glimpsed away to the safety area. Pylite die. Now he can buff up Arteezy, but Arteezy walled, locked him. The tether broke as well. He wants to go for more. No Fear is so low on life. Eternal Envy just needs 5 more seconds. Then you've got your Omni Slash away from the Creep Wave. He goes inside the spin. Now Omni Slash back off cooldown and God isolated with no spirit available.
Oh,
he only used a side of fist. Now Envy, maybe he can actually find more. You kill off the Alchemist, but God bouncing around. There's his spirit back up and he kills.
My God.
He actually kills Eternal Envy. VP are down to 2. God's gonna actually make it even better. He just keeps going ham. The Wave of Terror. You swap Universe back in. 1 second left and then Universe is dead. God just waits for it. No, he balls it up. He didn't actually hit the side of fist, but still, it's an ultra kill for God. I don't know. Io just seemed to gift his head on a silver platter. The ethereal gift from Team Secret.
All right. G's back on top, guys. He's here.
Death Prophet
versus Team Secret on Star Ladder.
I think it's a kind of fight location where Secret have these big team fight spells in vacuum.
They see this. Silent hunting. He's getting close. He's gonna assume that Envy has. Oh no, maybe not. Time walk in.
Oh.
Ooh. 5 seconds on the boots of travel.
Close.
This could actually end poorly for Eternal Envy, but Puppy is here in position to either get the swamp out or at least save his buddy. Lil Hardy getting caught out, dropping quickly to the illusions. Manages to chuck out of Laguna. It's on to Puppy. Still waiting for that Chrono Fear from Silent. The wall gets the point. Everybody already so low. Time walks out of the damage. Still waiting for the Chrono. He just can't find an opening. He finally drops one. It's only a Wii. How there's no damage going into it. Death Prophet against the world as the rest of VP get pulled apart. 4 now down. And they're gonna try to cage the Ghost Lady and stun there. A lot of heroes tanking the damage and being surrounded. Boulders getting kicked around. An army of Naga illusions swatting away at her. She still survives. Heads to the north. Turns with the nukes. Those boulder wildly off the mark from Pi. But the ghosts are coming back soon. Almost gets 2 more kills with that last nuke. Still tanking through everything. Eternal Envy is throwing at him. Might even kill all the backliners if they're not careful. Now the Spirit Slave is going to get the net as it continues to just toss out nukes. Nobody can get close. Close to G, one man wrecking career, but at long last, they wiggled him down. He still gets the BKB, which he now pops. He throws out yet another wave of ghosts, and they're afraid. The Rain Boss, it's taken too long. The Lahardis come back in, and he wants to get involved. Finds the kill, manages to bring down the Naga. That's an unstoppable streak. And Puppy, although he's been pulled back, may actually go down. Lil's there with the quick grab, gets the long range, and then the stun, the nuke. It all began with G, and it ends with 2 very unexpected kills and creeps just storming down mid to finish what the heroes could not.
Na'Vi versus Gyrocopter. Star Ladder Finals.
And VG going 2-for-1 there, but largely a win.
Huge win. Exorcism is down, so VGR will push forward. Beastmaster's buying back. They want to go all in on this one. They'll have double roar in 30 seconds. Dendi going to preemptively buy back, but...
No Exorcism.
Yes, and VGR can look to still continue pushing. Probably want to wait out this roar before they really commit for it, but they'll at least poke with the Necrobook and the Gyrocopter. Aegis is up.
General jumping ahead, using time dilation. Just trying to buy time. He's going to be hexed out. There's going to be the call down. Sonic Wave General's gone. And Mikasa now jumping on top of Dendi. Dendi's down to half. He's down to nothing as VGR forces another buyout. The general wants to rejoin the battlefield.
They can't do it without Dendi, though. They just don't have the damage. Not just Dendi, art style. They have two biggest damage
dealers. No damage. Maybe a little.
Dijerah kind of tickles at this point, even with an AC. They're going for the throne.
Why wouldn't they? 90 seconds on Dindi. He's down the entire duration. No buyback.
Well, the one reason not to is that this Void's about to have a Chronosphere with an Enchantress backing him up. This is the last chance for Na'Vi. They need a big Chrono with Enchantress.
They've got an Aegis on the Gyro. Like, unless he's going to get a two-man Sphere.
Where's Atsal?
He can't get there. Mikasa will end up dropping, though. Good for them there. There's going to be the roar down on Art Style, and he gets four-staffed out of harm's way, at least for the moment. Yang still trying to pursue him out. He's using the Nature's Attendance to heal himself up. FY biding his time, sitting back, doesn't have a blink, doesn't have a force. There's going to be another Sonic Wave. General's going to be able to time walk off all the damage. Now a call down. Sineko and Dijerah are going to be caught in it. Now End, forcing his way back up. Here comes Mikasa using the Shivas. Dijerah has to turn and face his fate. Triple kill for Vici, and now General coming back in. Does not get Mikasa. FY forced to spin the Echo Slam. General is going to be brought down by the Rocket Barrage. Sineko has to roll himself away. Dijerah back up, trying to right-click him down. Can he do it? Even if he can, it's just going to be the Aegis. End, just being kited around. There's another Sprout from Dijerah, just buying time as long as he can. Nothing he can do. He's now going to try to chase down the Prophet. Now another Sprout. There's going to be the boulder kick. Just look at this. This is ridiculous. It's like they're toying with him. And there we go. The Aegis is gone. The Aegis just expired. Na'Vi managed to hold against all odds.
I am speechless.
There's what? Your idea for your next custom game, guys. Kite the Gyro. Oh, my goodness.
What? A play from Dijerah.
Medusa versus TP Scroll. Mars TV Dota League.
Is unfortunately where she has to fight, and if MVP can control where she stands with walls and rock drops and chronospheres, it is not going to be a good time for Super, and it is shown in these past two ridiculous fights that it's not working as it is. But here they are. They are able to find a timing window.
They can steal this.
Move
they
can fall. Can they move in? Oh, the song gets up. Are they going to be able to take it? Well, they're starting with an illusion.
Back onto
that's
the wall,
it.
Maybe?
No?
CKB's flying out.
They get back into the high ground if he was close enough. Velo goes for it. He is going to be able to get Super to the high ground now. That's the Medusa. Not going to get pulled up. Yao's going to get brought down. Super goes for the stone gate. The fall-off will be the Chrono right there on top of it. But Qo was caught inside as well. Debbie looks in to go for Monet. They get a shred through him with the Manta with the Fusel. And they will not get that. The Eels will come off, but they will bring him down. Super, the big boss, hanging on the high ground now. Febby's going to jump on up and will be able to bring him down. That's the wall just hanging on top of him. It's going to be bad from here on forward. He's got the Aegis, but I don't know if he's going to be able to live through this second life. Too long, they look to go for Xiaowei, and he lives long enough so that the boost of travel can come in for Monet. Monet's here to fight now. He's looking to go for Dubu. Can he grab him? He's trying to get him, but Qo will not allow it. Another song comes off now. Locking Monet in place and giving up time for Dubu to charge
Dusa,
away.
Dusa's still on the high ground. She's trying to get a TP. Somebody snipe
she
that
is stuck. Courier's on the roof! Dubu can't see it! So it's going! Meanwhile, Dubu's in trouble himself! Modem's looking to move in, can he get him?
He can't!
Dubu charges and bumps
him back!
Back
out! Meanwhile, base in trouble, by the way!
They cancel Super's TP! They put a rock on him, he's still stuck on that high ground! What is going on? Another TP's coming! Meanwhile, inside the base, Qo's going to work. He's hitting the ancient. The ancient's going down.
The TP's on CD for 50 seconds. They're out of Super for 50.
This is the worst thing ever for LFY. The racks are dropping. This is going to be Megas. How unfortunate for the LG squad. And look at who he has been the mouse. I get these guys running all around. They get the Megas. I can't believe it. Super still on the back. He's still off of there. He's stuck. He's never joining this fight.
All right,
I've never seen
more
this.
Seconds. Oh my god, they dropped the rock.
Oh
now.
My. They dropped.
Okay, he's okay. He's different now. But look at the face. The face is fucking beat the throat. They're
gonna get it. SMP have done it. Oh my god.
Team Liquid versus LGD on Manila Major.
Hoping with the help of the Bounty Hunter, they can get a quick bounty kill and keep LGD a little bit off pace here. Sep is going to be the target, but not sure if they have the burst damage to really get him before Icarus Dive or Supernova. They start backing themselves away. The Hawk is doing some scouting here, and now Mutombo Man realizes just how many heroes of LGD are actually here. It's Invis Rune.
The two heroes are from the side.
Oh, the smoke beetle, the Rune and the Ravage! Five-man set up right into the Static Storm. The Anvil gets dropped by LGD, and they take four just like that. An ultra kill for Jerix, of all people. And now maybe he's looking for the great escape through the trees, but he's already been hit by the track. Liquid not going to try and go for the dive, though. Liquid see the opportunity to take a bigger objective in mine.
Miracle versus TNC on the International 2016.
And they still do not have a gem. Demon has chosen to invest in Sentry Wards instead, which is lackluster. Oh, they do have a smoke?
Yeah, they have a smoke.
Okay, I didn't see it.
But they're too late. Roshan's dying way too quick. OG does so much money. The Dias can on the side. Sam's on his way, but Roshan's down. Now TNC, the choice is there. Do you want to try and fight? Blink Rush, they close the range on Nose Helper. Crit with the E-Blade. Almost killing off Sam. The Nova in a great position on the hillside, but they both get four star out. Moon, is he locked in the tree line there?
Yep.
He may not have an easy way out. He's dodged his own TP. Does not want to wait even for Blink Dagger to come off cooldown. As OG. Disruption just on Raven. From the greatest time in the world, Moon looking to flank around from the side, get a blink call if possible. He's gonna find one, but he's gonna get the proper call. Slaughter pushed himself away with the blink dagger just fast enough that Moon will go down. Tinker's the man to find that kill. Then they're looking for more. Miracle comboing up the big Deathly Blast, a double Deathly Blast! Thunder will save Raven, but it won't save the rest of his team. Yule Scepter spinning it round. He'll just keep hitting up. Is he ever going to hit the ground right now? The Skydiver Raven will finally drop. A double for Crick, a triple for Miracle. And that should almost be the game right there. With no Terra Blade, you can bring back the Tinker. But OG's just got such a huge arsenal.
Team Secret versus Team Liquid on Shanghai Major.
Secret now just looking for any opportunity they can get. They know they cannot give Liquid this Roshan. If Roshan goes Liquid's way, this is definitely going to be a next set of racks. It's too hard to fight into, given how much they've been allowed to get in the last 5 to 10 minutes, so.
Buyback still on cooldown for a minute here for Envy, and now Envy jumps in. Onto mind control, he's got to play this money. We'll get the Shadow Dial bounce off in time. The BKB on the Silver Man, he turns around, drops the sanity, slip, they'll lose Misery. They'll lose Pilot Dial as well here. Up here, Lehigh and Envy in the middle of it all. BKB being popped by Envy, jumps for him. Can't get the rat drop to the Silver Man, he's trying to chase down the OG. We'll get a touch on with the defensive answer here. Buy him a two amounts of time. The Sun's trying to time him. Oh, not quite there. He'll get himself out here. The OG, there's a buyback here from mind control. Nice tornado coming down through the midst of the wall, but they get the stun. The snowball onto Envy. Dark packs up, continues to run. We'll get silenced. Envy on the retreat. Looks like he will be able to get himself out of there. But a bit of a messy fight, and we can see on the recap a few buybacks exposed there. Mind controls and Highlight Eyes coming through. But off the back of it, the worst thing that the Secret wanted there. They may lose Roshan, and as you said, this is going to be massive for Liquid. Envy, okay, that's a freebie. That's a freebie in this big one. 50 seconds, no touch.
They can go on then.
Oh, Kuroki getting shot forward, but he's there coming in as well. The call Kuroki out of the side, and he's going to go down. That's a really good. Now let's see if Envy gets it back in. There's a huge stun for Pi. Onto the Tumor Man, final spot to be getting, but Envy, he never stands. He gets tied up. The sun is in one of the reach. The Destiny Blast for We Are. Then throws out by control. Just tried to have Envy lives. The boy who lived, Eternal Envy. And We Are had his back just at the time it was needed. Fantastic combo from the Evoker coming down that choke point. A Secret do it. They'll move into Rose. They'll finish it off. They'll get themselves the Aegis. And what a game two we've got here, Andy.
OG versus Wings on the Summit 5 Finals.
So, yeah.
Yeah, and the rule.
I think they were like just all click the buttons at the same time.
Yeah.
Just throw everything at him, someone's gonna get through. And obviously with that play, OG into Roshan. See if Wings can do anything to cancel it. Still with 15 seconds without that boy, he's not gonna be around in time. They are gonna have Oracle back, so four of them are ready. Any kind of play that they can go for, Wings are still in position.
Kay always trying for the cow, jumps in, oh he's got it! He got the kill and he got the Aegis! Oh my goodness, he will go down, but absolutely, oh! The Void here with the two-man chrono! Can they get the 4-3 damage? There'll be a grave onto Noctowl, keeping him alive, crit, falling low, they'll be able to take down the Doom. Noctowl trying to fight back with the bashes, they're looking for the breaker, the 4-3, they're gonna find 4 wings! What a Roshan contest, jumping in on the breaker. You said it, Matty, you keep talking up this offlaner, but plays like that, that changes the whole goddamn game.
Refresher versus Team Liquid on Boston Major.
This game, he said, don't worry, Jerry, I'll help with some words.
Yeah.
And Jerry was like, okay, Anthony, thanks.
Oh, another
comp. Oh, they see this man, Anthony, that's under a ward.
Yeah, they had to do this for comp.
Oh no, so oh no, this could be disaster. Oh wait.
No, bottom, the owner sits as closer, but they have no followers. Hanskin does a lot though. Is it enough?
Kill a Sun King!
Oh, Sun King's still alive, he has shield, he's really tanky.
He was by bottom.
Yeah.
He's still alive!
He just
the bottom didn't want to kill him.
That took mercy.
It is the combo to Oli.
Yeah, Hanskin e-bladed him and Yunus and Pan couldn't click him.
I saw that, he couldn't click him, yeah.
Kind of forgot that he was put, I guess. So he thought Sankin would die from it.
That was kind of scrappy. They saw them run at ulti.
They
didn't run under ward.
This is it.
This is
they do have some.
They don't have PK.
He bought the pressure. He got a 4-4 back.
Oh,
holy shit.
With the turn
of Doomies. Holy shit, boss. Oh my god, that was such a play. They did not see that coming.
Holy I didn't see it coming.
I was looking at the top of the screen. I was like, why the fuck does he have a green thing under his name? And I was like, oh.
Miracle versus Escape Gaming. Captain's Draft 3.0.
There, like, those are a couple of good pickoffs, but Koifa needs a big core pick.
Oh, he's trying!
And he might have it.
Here. He's going in and gets stunned up. Oh, golly gee, the Kragi flies, shut the fuck up! We're moving into a team fight here. There's going to be a BKB. They clean up the sniper. They're looking for Koifa as well. There's going to be a nice forest truck connected up to Beastmaster. He doesn't have the refresher. He already popped it off. This is going to be in here. The Appy coming in. Miracle, he's getting low. He's going to get snipped down here. Looking to turn this around. He's done. He does not have buyback. Matumba Man and Tiny still bringing a lot of damage to the fight, but Escape, they're moving out as quick as their little legs will make them go, and looks like Trixie as well as Cinderin should be able to get out alive.
Actually, Sand King's on the mark here. If his spidey senses or whatever's going on, if he actually finds
Trixie's on another level right here. He's just feeling the pulse of this game, and that's going to be Gyrocopter going in. Pops the BKB.
Oh, they don't have Boots of Travel 2 on point.
Trixie? He's going to be force-tapping himself out here, and looks like there's going to be the Global Silence. They're trying to reinitiate onto the Tiny. The rest of Escape is behind them. Trixie taking the damage, but is it going to be enough to set up the fight? The rest of Escape are coming in, and Trixie's still alive. He will end up burning the Master Pyre because the Chrono stuck him up, but this is worth it. Escape, they're showing it. They've got this fight. Koifa, he's getting low. It's time for enough to damage. Mind control, he'll be going down. Everyone on Liquid has buyback, but Escape have done what they need. They've forced the kills. They're going to force the buybacks as well, and there is going to be a Tier 2 top, but mid lane gonna be cleared out of racks. Bottom lane looks to be this next target they're going in for.
The next level brilliance of Trixie. He's like, haha, you idiots, you thought I was just being a dumbass and feeding sometimes, not me, you know. They he lured them into a false sense of security where they're like, oh, Trixie's alone by himself.
Dude, he's going in. They're gonna be bringing in the sniper as well, and there's the hex. That's gonna be a kill on the gyrocopter. That's a dieback. This could be it. They get the Rubik as well. Everyone's starting
God.
To fall. Trixie, that buyback was worth it. That rotation was worth it. It took Escape to have that special kind of crazy player on their team to go in and make those plays. But it looks like we are going to be closing out this game relatively soon.
Oh, again, God. Tiny. Miracle's going for the throne, though.
He's gonna be stunned up. It's got the damage. There's gonna be the pure ice trap coming in. The throne is half health. Meanwhile, the rest of the Dire, they're still doing their work. Cinderin, he's getting low. There's a refresher. They've got another roar. Are they doing this? Yapzor, meanwhile, in the
Raiden
other base, is
half
doing
health.
It. Oh, God, they're doing it. Oh, no. Base Race coming in. Yapzor, he he's getting it down. Oh, he's got the blitz though.
No.
No
goddamn way.
What?
Evil geniuses versus OG Mars TV Dota League.
But you'll leave with bragging rights and probably a cool trophy. Probably a Reaver, right? I want to say that their trophy's a Reaver.
Battle Fury?
Battle Fury, whatever.
I don't know.
The TI sure probably, the Major probably owns a Reaver.
Whoa, 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 whoa,
okay,
whoa.
Okay, EG taking a page out of Secret's book. They do the five-man movement right down the mid lane, and the cross pass. Huge stun comes out on the back of the disruption play onto Onyx. Can they get the finish? They can. And here we go, folks. Game three action underway. Jarek seeing the brunt force of the damage. Hides around the trees, but the Glaze are going to be coming through, and they're going to get that kill. Also, good torrent connection onto S4. A follow-up secondary stun is going to be there onto two, as another one's going to get dropped. It makes it three down all day from OG. They're also going to be looking for No-Tail. Will they actually somehow make it four before the 1 minute mark? Yes, they will. They time it out nicely. That's a disruption into a torrent, into a stun, and EG are here to play in game three. 5-0, Ben.
Oh
as
my
the
God.
Horn goes out. Where's the good luck, have fun right now,
that
please.
That was disgusting. They thought they could take this fight because Napalm's pretty strong at level one.
And they're going to level one Roche. No, I'm just kidding.
But the... Oh my God, the Atis Spray plus the Luna Glaze did so much damage that fight. I don't think I've ever seen a 5-0 wipe at the start.
Puck versus MVP. MPGL Grand Finals.
Everywhere else he wants to be on the map. It's Meepo getting out of hand. Clear 1K ahead of QO's Ember Spirit at this stage of the game. Top lane, MVP maybe looking to fight. They're grouping up.
They have to try and use the window before Meepo gets his Aghanim's and play the fight.
Get the tower, but MVP have to be careful. Febby's going to drop the ult. Burrow Strike comes in return for BYB. Epicenter being charged up, and here we go. On to Febby. Bring him down low, but the defense and destruction for Dumu. Now the Demonic Purge on BYB. MVP looking for the turnaround. They take down a second double kill for Febby. Ryzen falling low, but Gabby has got the damage. He does take to the Warlock, but he's almost certainly going to pay him his own life. Silas hit the ball. No! Gabby's styling over the wall. He gets himself a double kill and he lives through it all. Can they actually kill the puck? They'll get the flame break back, but Gabby blinks down, jumps back in.
What?
Gabby, Gabby, Gabby! Oh my God!
You see what he just did? He bought the bling at the base and he sold it.
Oh my God!
He sold his bling and he bought his bling again on the side shop to blink out.
Blade Mail versus Rapier on Boston Major.
As well, this next 5 minute window for both sides could be the be all end all for both teams.
I see Sniper, what's he gonna do? Rape your time, drop your boots of travel, rape your time.
Oh,
there we go.
Goodness.
If you die, you've lost the game.
If you die, you've lost the game.
So, I mean, without the rapier, it's the same case. So, it's like you die without a rapier, you lose the game. You die with a rapier, you lose the game. It's the same thing. You may as well have a rapier, Owen. And a casual blade mail, okay. I mean, considering the BKB durations, this is an item that could be very effective. You use a Manta, you pick up... It's actually going to drop the Radiance. Late game Blade Mail with 2.6k HP. We're watching when a 2.2k gold item is your ideal six-slotted Alchemist item.
Well, we'll see that one nerf next patch.
Oh.
There we go. Already looking for the fight here, but crit. Oh no, no one's going to be so careful. They've got the water. No. No one! Oh no, not the rapier! They've got the disruptor, but passes over the back. I'm chosen with the cross. No one turns around.
Don't hit the Alchemist! Oh, he hit the Alchemist!
He's down! No one hits the deck! They've lost Lil as well! Round Aziz is going to be dropped. EG! Oh, and then the Maya just done it here, and they have! GG is called. That one on the high ground. VP were not prepared for that.
OD Pixel versus Ad Finem, Boston Major Grand Finals.
77 minutes in.
This could be it. Juggernaut is up in 30 seconds, but I don't know if 30 seconds is going to be long enough. They could just rush for the throne. They only have
5 seconds with a clip.
On the high ground. Looking for the setup. Burrows up. There's the jump in. They found the fissure into the sun. It's a matter of what the BKB. The Eclipse. They focus down S4, but he uses himself up. Buys time, but they're already moving forward. They're heading for the big kills. Looking for Anna. Skylight's taken down. The Shadow Demon with the jewel. S4 jumps forward. Looks for the stun. The Orbi starts from no doubt. They foul Skylight. Madden jumps low, but he's got the Aegis. He's going to be back for round two. Buyback from Skylight. Bosses across. Getting himself back in the fight. And in comes Spartan again with the stolen Orbi slash. Jumps down Anna. The engine is open. They're looking to finish the game here. Maybe next time looking for Jack, but Madara is hitting the engine. The engine's falling low. And Adminem, they're on the verge of doing it. Oh, maybe next time comes in with the Echo Snap. They just need a few more touches on that engine. It's incredibly low. Can they do it? Doug jumps forward, looking to finish it, but he's not going to do it. The OG have held. They have held.
310 HP left on the Dire Ancient. And Luna, I don't think, was close enough to actually get her blaze off onto the throne. Divine Rapier drops. No Tail now is the Proud Wielder. So no glyph up. They could technically just smoke up and finish it off with their next buyback.
I don't think maybe next time goes for that.
There
sort of
is just way too much armor on that Ancient. 15 armor. Is he going for it?
No, he's not.
He is going for it.
Oh, no. Oh my god. I can't believe he did it! He's gonna do it with an absolute dart! They've done it, Ben! It's not the 3-0 that it looked to be! It's 2-1! Adminem have taken a game against OG! This smiles on No Tail! This smiles on me! Adminem coming out, they can't believe it! They cannot believe it! MMT gives a quick nod to the crowd!
TNC versus OG. The International 2016 Elimination Match.
Kala mo talaga, pumalakbak sa manok, ano ba yun? Kwento niya sa manok!
Ay, bibili ng Divine. Gugusto niya mag-Divine, pre.
Sino gugusto?
Gugusto niya mag-Divine.
Ay, sus! Kala mo naman talaga.
Kala mo naman uubra sa amin yan.
Kala mo talaga.
Pag nahuli ka ni Jorge.
Pag ikaw na, Krono! Op, 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 op. Parang chest lang to. Matehan. Matehan. Oh, piyaman eh, Popcorn. Ay, kala mo talaga! Kala mo talaga, Papi! Papi Chulo! Oh, yeah! Oh! Sabi mo!
Oh! This is the round! Sabi ka! The monster is the win! The monster! Oh! It's over! It's over! Oh! Nako mo! Nag-divide daw si Miracle! Nag-divide! Oh! It's over! Oh my God! TNT! TNT doing it!
Oh my God!
Ay, nako! What a game! What are you doing? Bakit ka nag-divide? Why did it
happen? Why did you do this? OG! What are you doing?
Nice throw, Bobby!
TNC!
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 Oh my God! Kangkong sila, Papi Chulo!
Kangkong
ako, OG!
Alam ang gagawin mo! Champion pala kayo na Major City ngayon!
Ay, nako, bes!
Uwi!
Uwi kayo, Papi D!
Yeah. If you want to cheese, you do it the first game, because the second game your opponent won't know what you're going to do.
But then aren't the captains already thinking there's going to be a cheese first game, I'll draft against them?
I mean, you do not want to out-mind game yourself. Losing one game because you kind of trick yourself.
Hit very hard early on, and that's something Alliance are going to have to be very wary of.
This could be a wraparound here. EGM sneaking in as the Invis rune, and they're going to start this off with the Shadow Strike. There are two charges up on the Spirit Siphon, though, so they're going to need to burst him. If he gets one off, they might have to disengage, but they get the lift. Then the drop comes through, and he's a bit late there on the Fairy Fire. His Spirit Siphon, though, gets taken out. He ends up getting the first blood. Two for the rescue. Potato Tornado. It looks like it's going to be a 2-0. Mineski salvaging that and coming out way on top.
It looked like for a second he'd made a mistake about using the Spirit Siphon earlier, but boy, does he barely survive. Two Null Talismans, the extra survivability that he got from that.
30
opportunities are there between our two offlaners. The starkest difference is going to be between our four positions. Axe is much more likely to spend his time full on trying to farm away, while Kuro, obviously on the Doom, is going to be trying to pressure the Axe and might just be able to find it here. DJ, he's left with only 75 HP. He's going to try and juke his way through the trees. Eats a tango. Kuro turns the wrong direction and might not be able to get him in time. Chases all the way right into the tier 3 area, but won't be able to pick up that kill, and may just have to suffice with just a pickup on that Hellbear. Now picks up his level 2, but DJ, he's already gotten the healing salve up. A man fight between the two, but mid one, he's going to make it a 2-for-1. It never comes in. The sun strike over the top, and this could be our first one as DJ cleans through with his axe.
Great heads-up play from DJ to turn that around with the salve. And Kuro, biggest issue for him is that he found such a kind of worthless creep. He had
classic items for these heroes. The Necro 3 online now. An Alliance creeping forward, but Bineski appear to be wise to this. They do have the ward. They see it coming.
They want to fight while X is on cooldown, but at the same time, initiating on Death Prophet, who has an Aegis, not ideal.
Oh, they are going to head up the hill. They find Jules first. That's a little bit sweeter, but Bimbo's gotten off a really nice nuke there from the Veil, and now they move on to Bulldog. The Exorcism coming. He's got a double Spirit Siphon. They cannot fight him head on. They're trying to kill up the backliners, but they've already lost two. Big Pores hitting the deck, and Luna coming next. EGM choked down. That's going to be 3. Mineski pushing for 4. Luna might be next. Just need one more auto attack. He turns his back. He heads for the hills. The Wave of Terror's there. They get him in the Sprout. They need that Vent Stun to complete it. The Quills stack up, but it's not enough. It's 4 down. Necro will finish off one lingering Mineski hero, while Bimbo chases forward. That's one angry potato. He does the rules, doesn't need it. It's a wipe. Mineski cleaning up there. It did cost them a buyback, but well worth it.
Oh boy, Mineski taking out the entire Alliance squad. But nope, they're ready. They've actually got a smoke. They can bypass the Hawk with this, but
there is no way they take this in time. Fnatic need to get out. Mushi is going to be stunned by the boulder smash. They're going to come through. Shawit looking for Ravage. Can't find it. Mushi pops the BKB early. Aggressive blinks in. Pops the Rage as well. Still has his BKB ready to go. They really want to contest this and take it down as quickly as possible. They get the refresher for Ohio. It's coming out. Double Roar is ready. Can they find a kill off of this? Maybe he's walking up with a Silver Edge. Ohio's going to get caught first. Ravage catches on to 2. Black Hole counter initiation. Static Storm on top. Aggressive is low. They get off the Static Storm. Shelly pops the refresher. It's not enough. Maybe he's getting chewed through by mid 1. They get off the Roar. They'll lose 2. They'll lose 3. They buy back on the Tide. He's got another Ravage. They have no buyback on Maybe. What an initiation from DJ. And they'll find another one. They get MMY. Mid 1 gets a double. The crowd is going absolutely freaking nuts, guys.
I just like took my headset off. I'm like, whoa.